It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. This scenario is based on the HipLocal case study. HipLocal needs to migrate their existing data analytics platform to Google Cloud without any major change in code. Which service should they use? So HipLocal already has some data analytics platform. We want to shift that to Google Cloud without incurring any cost in terms of rewriting the code or changing the code. This is what we would call a lift and shift migration. Whatever existed on-prem, we want to move to the cloud. Now, what did HipLocal already have? Looking at the case study and the existing technical environment within that, we can see that the data analytics is performed in an on-premises Hadoop environment. So they were using Hadoop. One thing to know is that when shifting from on-prem Hadoop or Spark to Google Cloud, Dataproc is the first solution that you should consider, provided we have to reuse all the jobs that exist. So when there are no changes in the code, and when you don't want to be rewriting code, then Dataproc should be a first option. If rewriting the data processing is an option, then we could consider the managed service Dataflow. Now let's look at the options. Option A suggests cloud storage. Now, this could be useful for storing the data for analytics. However, it is not an analytics platform by itself. The input to the analytics and the output from the analytics or the data processing could be saved on cloud storage. By itself, it does not give us analytics. So option A is out. How about cloud data flow? As we discussed earlier, Dataflow is a managed service and is great when you want to have data processing for both batch and stream, and you know you don't want to take care of the lot of the operations overhead. However, in this case, we will have to rewrite some code because the technology used is different compared to Hadoop. Now, rewriting the code is not something we want specifically in this requirement. Therefore, cloud data flow is not a good option for us. Option D suggests that we use a persistent disk. But like the option of cloud storage, this is simply a place where we can store data. By itself, it is not an analytic solution at all. Therefore, we can easily eliminate option D. Option C suggests cloud Dataproc. Now we know this is the case that when we want to shift from on-prem Hadoop or Spark to Google Cloud, Dataproc is the option when you do not want to have any changes in code. So whatever jobs we are running on-prem, we can reuse the same thing on Google Cloud. Therefore, considering these, option C to use cloud Dataproc would be the right solution in this case when you want to do a lift and shift migration of Hadoop from on-prem to Google Cloud. All right, now it's time for you to like, share, comment, and subscribe. Go ahead, do that right now, because there's loads of great content coming up for learning Google Cloud and preparing for the certifications.